Welcome back to the Manor Entropians, Julian McBain here. And today what we're going to do is we're going to be hunting Panleons. I've decided to do some low-level hunting for a little bit to try and see how the returns add up. But the other thing I wanted to do was I really wanted to get in with the Maze Hammer and see how that worked out and grind out my clubbing skill. Because why wouldn't you? I mean, this is how bad I am at clubbing. Look how slow I'm moving. So I figure it's a good opportunity to grind that up a little bit. Let's see what my skill level is with this. Oh, apparently I maxed out on attacks per second, or attacks per minute. It's just slow. Which is not surprising. I mean, look at the size of that hammer. Why is that necessary? But I think it'll definitely help with my other damage skills. So we'll see how that works out. I mean, I could be totally wrong. The meshed effect of hit and damage skills between melee weapons, much like in ranged weapons, isn't well known. It's not what I'd call well documented. So it'll be an interesting experiment. Now the real question is, do I get myself in so deep that I end up getting in trouble? Which happens. Now, what is the decay rate on this? It's only 2 per strike, which means you get about 250 strikes with it before it dies. Because it's, what, 5-ped? Yeah, it's a 5-ped club. So, not terrible. I'd say it's probably similar to my Laconian sword. I know the damage is similar, except this is a hell of a lot slower. Which I get. Evade. Honestly, it might be more cost effective just to use the gun. But this allows me to farm some shrapnel and replenish my ammo stock. Since for some reason Mindark's web store hasn't been working, and actually I haven't tried it recently, like in the last couple days. But come on. I haven't seen an announcement, so I doubt that Mindark's fixed it, which I think is much to their detriment, because some of us prefer to do things like buy strongbox keys or universal ammo instead of just depoting PED. It's more cost efficient. And honestly, I think that universal ammo is more burn efficient, which I know it technically isn't, it's all the same, but whenever I swap to blue ammo, though, the weapon cells, or to the synthetic mind essence, it just feels like I go through it faster, which I know is completely in my brain and not real life, but it does, it feels that way. And I think it's because you're burning PED, which you're burning PED anyway, but you know what I mean. I am honestly impressed at how slow this thing is. I'm also impressed at how bad I am with it. It's like, here, have a mob that shouldn't evade you at all. But I'm used to using a sword and not a club. I gotta say, the Maze Hammer is an interesting weapon. The fact that you have to buy it using shrapnel, so I bought this tonight. It's Saturday night. No, I'm not doing that, you fool. You know what? If they're gonna pull that crap, I'm just gonna stand here and shoot him. Oh, there he is. I'm like, I know there was a sweater around here somewhere. Tempest. Freelancer. Hmm. Probably dropped a cat, eh? Grab your gun, bring in the cat. That was a good series. You know, I did some low-level hunting on stream on Friday, and my returns were actually not bad. I think I totaled out being like one ped and a smidge loss, which is not significant, and it's all based on drops. So really, if your gains or losses are within a ped, you broke even. Honestly, if you're within 5 ped, you're really broke even, especially when you hit like the level I'm at. Because sometimes you're going to have really good loot, and sometimes it's going to be a little weaker, but it all evens out. Now, if this trails into like 10 or 15 ped or 50 ped, well, then you have a problem. And maybe you need to kind of look at how you're hunting or what you're hunting and determine a better course of action. I will say it's nice to have the starter area where you can hunt all the low levels and it's separated from the rest of the world. Sorry about that, I had to sneeze. Because you're not going to run into other things. And I know that like Calypso has Icarus and Half Moon Bay. But I don't know, it's just I think it's because it's an island. Maybe that's it. Maybe I feel that way because it's an island. Doesn't have to make sense. I'm trying to remember what village that is. Oh, that's the yep, the Zin immigration area. Scrap metal. Oh. Okay. That reminds me, at some point I am going to have to pick up an LR weapon again and go hunting bots. See if they're still in the same area. Actually, this gun should be sufficient for bots. Maybe that'll be Tuesday's stream. There's a lot of areas I need to re-explore. Because, like, this whole section here didn't exist. Right? And this whole island chain, if I remember correctly, did not exist. And there were islands here. And this whole island archipelago did not exist. Which we know this is 100% mining. There's a lot here to explore that needs to be explored again. So that's going to start happening. Like, we dealt with the dusters, we've dealt with the plants. That's all fine. We know that stuff over here is higher level-ish. And we have all of the new Tideclaw area. I don't remember what's on the back side. I think this is Tideclaws 2 here. I think they're still there. But, like, over here by this teleporter, the Great Plains. I think there were Panleon out there the last time. I'd have to go look. And where are those damned monkeys? You have to hunt them forever for the epic fat mission chain. So I think we got some exploring to do. This area is pretty cool, but there's still nothing there. And I would love to know how to get to these two flying orbs in the sky, which you can actually can't see from this position, ironically. Probably too far away. Or they're behind this wall. Which is far more likely, now that I made you all dizzy. But see, this is why I like Entropia. You know, there's so much to do. There's so many varied places to hunt. There's so many different things to do. Atlas Hunting Grounds. I don't remember the Atlas Hunting. I mean, I remember them being there. I just don't remember what was on there. Oh, I think this is where I was hunting pleaks. That could be. But you should never get bored here. And I mean, this is just one planet, and there's like seven biomes. You've got the high desert, you've got the low desert, you've got Carnap's Landing, you've got this, whatever this is, you've got mining here, you've got the Pantan Jungle, you've got the plains. Don't even bother trying to pronounce that. Merfolk Island is over here. Actually, I think Mer Beach Teleporter. That's it. Nope, we had a bit of lag. So there's plenty here. And there's a whole interesting zone down here. Which I wonder, was that all there the last time? I'm going to have to look at my old videos. Because I think some of this is new too. Whiskers. I am wondering what Cyrene team has in store. And I'm kind of excited to find out. I'm hoping that sometime in the time that I spend here, there's going to be an event of some sort, so I can see what they come out with. Because I think that'd be a lot of fun, you know? Participate in a local event, which I haven't done a Cyrene event yet. You know, I've done Calypso events, of course. I've done Monrea events. I have yet to do a Cyrene event, and I think they do them monthly. So I think it'd be really cool to catch one. So we'll see what happens. Olive paint. I love how much paint you can pick up here. It's like everything has paint in its system. This must be where all of the crafters get their paints from. It's like, go send someone to Cyrene and get them to smuggle paint back to Calypso. It's like, this isn't super common. And this one's even less common. I mean, yeah, you need a lot of it. But who cares if you're getting 160% out of it? Between that and all the 101s, you know, you use the 101 stuff to keep you moving. And then you get the real profit off the 150, 160. And I think that's one of the things that people don't really appreciate is if you have the guts and the know-how and you know which routes to go in order to avoid pirates, I think smuggling goods from Cyrene back to Calypso is lucrative. You just got to be patient. Now, of course, if you lose a load, you're fucked. And I totally recognize that. And here I am putting all this content out for the world to see, saying you should smuggle ship between Cyrene and Calypso, which means some enduring pirate might just drop their quad wing in there and wait for some hapless player to take my advice. So let me throw out some pretty standard disclaimers. Traveling through space with loot does make it prone to being stolen by pirates. Travel in space is at your own risk. You decide to take loot in this space, you get shot down, and a pirate walks away with all of your stuff. That is not on me. You should have had either a co-pilot or an escort to jump aboard a mothership. When in doubt, ask the Normandy, because they don't bother telling you to log out. They just shoot the damn pirates down. Which is why, from what I've seen, pirates tend to not bother the crew of the Normandy. Because they know the crew of the Normandy will shoot their asses down. So just be prepared for that. Or charter a flight with a warp ship, a Pathfinder, or a star... What are they? The smaller frigate-sized ships. Or someone with an Equus. that can just jump. Because you can jump from non-lootable to non-lootable now. That's what it takes. That's the real meaning of, you know, doing business in Entropia. Why does it keep stopping? But it doesn't take much. It just takes some ingenuity. And now with the non-lootable zones being expanded so much, the ability to move goods and services between planets has gone up geometrically. Now, what will this do for prices? It's probably going to move prices down. That's usually what happens. Although some of this stuff, you just have to have the absolute patience to farm. Farming paint takes forever. And you got to know what mobs drop each individual color. And good luck finding black. If you find a can of black paint, you got it made. I don't think I've ever seen a can of black paint on the market. One can of black paint. 10 pack. Global! That'd be funny as hell. Get a global, it's all black. No, get a Hoff. It's all black paint. If that happened to anyone, they'd be fucking rich. Like, sell the black paint and buy a land area. Oh, there's two sweaters out here. Zigomaru. And Tempest. But this is the stuff I go into in the modern Entropian. You know, the limits of the platform are what you put on them. And maybe that's... I think that's something I'm going to have to go into. I didn't have the wherewithal to start tonight, but maybe that's what I'll do for Wednesday's video, is start in on pieces of the modern Entropian so you know what I've put in there, so it will make you, it'll allow you to have an educated decision on whether you want to join the Patreon to get a copy. It doesn't take much to create yourself a niche in Entropia Universe. Now for me, I took the most popular niche for overall, which is hunting, is my primary, but really my niche is content creation. Right? I create content for Entropians. That is my niche. My primary niche in the platform itself is hunting, which is the hardest profession to monetize. It's doable, but it's the hardest. But my real niche is this. I create this for Entropians. What niche will you come up with in Entropia Universe? It can be anything. You can form a taxi service. You can farm up a specific good because you happen to know where it is. You can become a miner. You can become a crafter, which takes a lot of outlay, but once you get there, there are people who have made their living off of crafting. Now, yes, this is an outlier, and past performance does not guarantee future results. But it's been done. And if it's been done once, it can be repeated. And I think that's something that a lot of people don't really appreciate, is that something that's been done once can be done again. It's replicatable. That's scientific method. If you do it once, it can be replicated. If it can't be replicated, it was a fluke. But if someone can make their living over time at it, like if you make 1 month's salary playing the game, that's a fluke. If you do it for a year, that's replicatable. Now the question is how do you replicate it? Right? And that's the real trick. Now, it'll be damn hard to replicate it off of something with a 101 markup. Realistically, the cost of auctioning that item is more than... The opportunity cost of auctioning that is more than the losses you take by TTing. And I hate to say that, but that's the case. In fact, that's pretty much the case for anything with a markup of less than 103. And part of that's because it's so low because the market is flooded. So just removing that item from the market altogether might be the best bet because that could bring back the price. On the other hand, you have this blue paint, which has 128% markup. That means it's rarer. It's less common, which means people are going to want it more. And it doesn't mean that there is going to be a huge demand for it, but those with the demand, and there will always be demand for crafting items like that, are willing to pay the price for it. Now, true, like all items, you have to sell it in 50 ped lots. Not easy to come by. You got to farm for a long time to do that. You're going to end up blowing through a lot of ammo. But all that does is build your skills up. So you got to make the decision. What is it you want to do? You know? Or you could just come here for social hour. I know people who play for social hour. They just come here, they chat. They might sweat in the fields on Calypso. And they're just here to chat. And they sweat so that their avatar is doing something, but they're really just here talking. And I've done that. I've done that for months on end where I'm like, I'm not really feeling playing the game, but I don't want to do nothing. And I like the community, so I'd go to like Club Royal and sweat mobs. And I did that for like 2 months. You know, I'd do my videos and I'd be hunting then, but when I wasn't doing videos, I'd just be sweating and be chatting. And you know, that's a good time. It's like sitting around a campfire, except there's an Amublamax in the middle instead of a flame. And it's trying to kill you one by one, and it usually does. So slightly different. But hey, this is Entropia Universe, right? Which means death has no consequence. You go back to Revive Terminal, and you run back out and start sweating the mob again. Because there's no point in having full health against something like an Amublamax when you don't have armor on. So you just take the L and let it go, right? But these are all things this platform is good for. Now, I will continue to farm and do what I do best, and I'm working on my mining skills now, trying to get the specific skills up that I have lacked so I can try and generate more in-game money so that I'm depositing less. And yeah, that's also why I have deeds and shares and stuff, but still, the idea is that you slowly build up and you build the skills necessary to get the profits in, which builds your passives, and then you can eventually use that passive income to do the hunting. And there are people who do that. Lore Spade does it, although he depots for most of his purchases for deeds. Serial Overdrive did it the hard way. He frickin' sweat the mobs, then he hunted, then he used the ped in order to buy the deeds, and ugh. You know, he may only get 5 ped a week or 50 ped. I think he makes like 50 ped a week. Or maybe it's not quite that much. I do know that when he does Entropia videos, he'll have like a storehouse of ped that he's been building up from deeds. Or he'll be putting it back into deeds. But he's never put one red cent into the game. You don't have to put money in. It just makes things a lot faster. And that's the hard grind. I think I go into a whole chapter of it. About the hard grind where you literally go in zero depot, you sweat the mobs to get the ammo, to hunt the mobs, to get the mats, to sell the mats, to get more money, to get more ammo, to hunt the mobs until you run out, or until you can buy like a deed, right? And you know, one underground deed is only going to provide you 30 peck a month. That doesn't get you anywhere. So you go back to the fields. Rinse and repeat. And it'll take you several years, but you'll accomplish it. I don't necessarily recommend it. But hey, if you're mostly there just for the community aspect or to chat, there's nothing wrong with that. And there are people who need the sweat. So, you know, carve your niche. Run a taxi, run a quad wing back and forth to various planets. I've done it. You can make like 5 ped on a run to most places. I mean, yeah, you're burning time and that's always an issue, but you know, you make 5 ped, you no longer have to spend money for atmosphere atmospheric interface. Just make sure that your passenger has the planet downloaded ahead of time. Because that's a pain. And then you're good. Oh, there it is. I was looking for that. So tell me what your niche is. And my intention for Wednesday's video is I'm going to start going into different parts of the modern Entropian. I will, of course, not be reading the book verbatim because that is the purview of my patrons. But I'm hoping to inspire you and help you find that niche that you need. So maybe that'll become a series. Like, is he gonna come this way, or... And just figure out where it is you want to be. What do you want to make of yourself on this platform? Because that's really what it comes down to. So we're gonna finish this guy off. Did pretty good for loot. Our hammer's down, not even close to half. And our gun's down, like a little over a pet. So we're doing pretty good. So anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Please like, share, and subscribe down below. We are on the road to 13 million subscribers, one subscription at a time. So make sure you subscribe. Also, big shout out to my patrons, Red Kryptonite, Jason Lambertson, and Spectrum 3900. Thank you so much for your support. And you can become a supporter too if you go to patreon.com/JulianMcBain, where you will get that copy of The Modern Entropian and my other ebook, Personal Finance for Gamers. All right, guys, I really appreciate all the support, and we'll see you in the next one.